De Klassieken Thuis. Met Maartje van Wegen.
En wat het leukste is, is niet met Maartje van Wegen. Nou ja, ook met Maartje van Wegen, maar vooral met de maestro zelf. Lang, lang gearriveerd. You're very welcome. We are very happy to see you here.
Thank you.
Dank u
wel.
It was quite last night. You had the concert and all people who wanted to speak with you. It was quite late last night. You're here. We spoke about you all morning. And we said all kinds kind things about you. We listened to your music, but now you're here. And I'd like to start this hour with you at the table with you and your father. Prinsengracht Concert, 2006. You're very kind about the concert. What do you remember about the moment that your father joined you and with his Eru?
Yeah, it was always very special when I have my father on stage with me because he... He sacrificed a lot together with my mom. They did everything to help me to achieve my career. And still today, still my mom travels with me, and my father taking a lot of things for me in China. And so, but more importantly, to perform on stage, it's really a lot of fun because we understand each other very well. And it's kind of like extension of our family tradition. When I was a kid, I remember every weekend we play family concerts, combined with Chinese instruments and other instruments, and we improvise on the keys, on the strings, and there was so much. I mean, I remember that's one of the most beautiful memory I had, and that also inspired me to be a musician because this freedom of making music. It's just wonderful to have him on that night in the Prinsengracht. Such a beautiful spot and to perform, kind of floating on the river, and it's just like a dream.
Okay, en die droom kunt u allemaal terug horen in dat fragment vader en zoon lang lang. Herinneringen aan vroeger met de familie, samen concerten maken. Ouders die zo belangrijk zijn geweest voor zijn ontwikkeling. Moeder die nu meegekomen is, vader die de zaken regelt in China. Prinsengracht Concert 2006, vader en zoon lang lang. Groot applaus. Prinsengrachtconcert 2006 voor vader en zoon. Lang, lang. The instrument your father is playing is erhu. 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 Ja. Twee snaren, sort of violin, maar dan met twee snaren. Very special and you were looking well, sort of proud with your father together. I start with the beginning. Tom and Jerry.
Yeah.
The cartoon. Yeah. Please, you were 2 years?
I was watching Tom and Jerry and the Cats Concerto really got me into the music world. I remember they were playing Hungary Absolute number 2.
But I didn't know Liszt.
Yeah, I only know Tom that time. No. I mean, when you were 2 years old, what do you know?
Yeah.
but that was a brilliant, innovative creation on cartoons. And from that point on, I became a big fan of cartoon because of that.
And of music.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's the kat die speelt op de piano en de muis die plaagt en doet. En klein fragmentje uit de Tom and Jerry tekenfilm. Okay. Very tiny part of the Tom and Jerry from your youth. Mm. Well, everyone knows you write about it in your autobiography also. And it was sort of a way for you to relax. You didn't get much time of your parents to relax, but watching cartoons was important for you.
Yes, every day I must have like 40 minutes of cartoon time. It gave me a lot of great joy and knowledge also, you know. I mean, actually cartoon is probably the best way for kids to learn. Also puppet, you know, like Sesame Street, for example. That's really the best way to learn your everyday life and to get your imagination work. And, you know, without imagination, as a human being, we can't develop.
No. It was a way for you to relax. Hè? Lang zegt, ik kon een beetje ontspannen met die tekenfilms. Ook belangrijk om wat je kinderen kan leren. Is there some time for yourself now, to leisure time, to do nothing?
Tomorrow I have a day off. Not in the evening, but in the morning I have a day off. I'm going to walk around a little bit. And, you know, it's great to be back in Holland. It's such a great air here.
But that's the way to relax, walk around.
Walk around and go to museums, I would say, especially here, you know, it's Van Gaal. I would say also watching football match.
Yeah.
That also was quite relaxing.
Yeah. It was a pity for you that you had to perform last night because there was the important match in the arena. But he didn't tell you.
I didn't know that actually.
Yeah. Otherwise you wouldn't have come.
It's actually good. Yeah, it's actually nice. I didn't know.
No.
I can focus more.
But it's one day tomorrow. Well, the day, just the day, not the evening. Mm-hmm. Is there much time for yourself left for personal life?
I mean, tomorrow I will not have a personal life. I mean, you know, but I mean to just relax, I think.
But in general.
But in general I do have a personal time.
Really? For friends? And you say in your book it's so important having friends
absolutely.
And relax and
normally I have a friend who travels sometimes.
With you.
Yeah. Not everywhere, but I mean, you know, sometimes I just get together with friends. And also, you know, when you're traveling a lot, you met people, and you know, the third time you become a good friend, you know, because every year I come back to the same city, and you have two or three, you know, really good friends, and I have a few in Holland, you know, it's like family, it's a really close friend. Yeah.
Okay, lang zegt, ik heb je overal op de wereld vrienden, je ontmoet elkaar een paar keer en dan ben je vrienden. But when about your schedule, you did the opening concert in Carnegie Hall, and after the concert you went to the airport and then to Shanghai, and then you did the opening of the season in Shanghai. Well, I think with jet lag and everything, it's becoming crazy.
It's all right. I mean, that's our life. I was you know, the day before yesterday, I was in Hong Kong and I fly into Amsterdam and had a little bit rest. And then yesterday was the concert. So, you know, I mean, this is hopefully, you know, normally what we are trying to do is every 3 months, I'm going to another continent. So like 3 months in Europe and then another 2 months in China and then 3 months in America. You know, so we try to pace the time a little bit. But unfortunately, you know, when you're doing opening season, and you know, I mean, when you were again opening, you know, for Carnegie, or opening or closing of the proms, that's like kind of a special time. And fortunately, you know, people invite me for those things. Okay. But also, in the same time, that we need to sacrifice a little bit on flying. But, you know, long distance flying is not that bad, actually. Yeah. Sometimes what I really not used to is that, you know, sometimes the city doesn't have a like direct flight within like 2 hours. So what you do is like you go to one city and you transit. So you get two like trips in 2 hours. That's really very demanding. But like, for example, like I was in Hong Kong the day before yesterday.
So I fly today.
You know, I mean, like the whole night I slept, like the flight is like 12 hours and 15 minutes. So it's almost 13. I slept the whole time. So I wake up. It's like 5 o'clock in Holland time, you know. And then, so I went back to the hotel and I slept to 12 o'clock. And then wake up, it's like perfect. Really, you know. Yeah. And sometimes when you have a long distance flight, it's actually nice that you can really chill down and not think about anything and not working and just sleep. So
okay.
It's
and jet lag, you don't speak about jet lag.
When you come from Asia to Europe, there's not much jet lag. Okay. But if you go back, that's jet lag.
Yeah.
Same thing. Like if you fly from Europe to America, it's no problem. But if you fly from New York or Los Angeles to Europe, that's a problem.
Yeah.
So it always depends how you do it.
Thank you. Weet alles natuurlijk van jetlag. Probeer er elke 3 maanden een ander continent. Maar ja, dan word je voor een heel belangrijk concert uitgenodigd, wat ook weer leuk is. Dan ga je natuurlijk. We hadden het over Tom en Jerry. Pas veel later wist Lang Lang, dat is de tweede Hongaarse rapsodie van Franz Liszt. En heeft hem natuurlijk ook gewoon gespeeld.
Thank you.
Lang Lang is quite surprised about the applause. It's applause for you.
Yeah, because the recording I remember was the studio recording, but this is a live one, so it must
be. This is a live one.
Where, do you know?
2006.
Oh.
In the concert building, concertgebouw.
Oh, that's right. Because I'm like, I mean, I have wow, that's a fast plane.
Yeah, well, that was you.
Faster than my normal recording, so because it's live.
Yeah.
See, that's
and when you play live, it was the Tweede Hongaarse Grand Prix, live, then there's difference. When you play live for an audience than in the studio, there's a difference. Between
slightly, particularly on those kind of pieces.
Yeah.
Vitrasic pieces.
Yeah.
Live, you kind of are more... You have a more kind of a free spirit, a little bit more.
Yeah. I think it was like magic last night. People with two encores and people, please come back. And already a standing ovation. It was...
Yesterday was a really good concert because the thing is what I like the most is really we get deep into the music, especially the slow movement and the color, because Concertgebouw is such an incredible building that you can shape up the frieze and colors like a first time, you know, when you're in this building, you're just like kind of making history, basically, you know, obviously, you know, in a way that everyone's making history, but it's just something really unique about it, that you don't find this kind of imagination, you don't find this kind of a creativity in other halls, because this hall inspires you like no other hall does.
Nee, zo speciaal concertgebouw, dat inspireert je en zo bijzonder allemaal. And you say, well, it was quite a good concert. I thought you never thought it was good, but it was good.
Yesterday was 100%. Good, I must say. I mean, you know, sometimes I'm always very critical, but yesterday was a really... really exciting, but in the same time, I got a lot of things, which I'm sure it's also because of the great audience and the great hall that inspired me a lot. I think yesterday the slow movement from Beethoven, from Abinitz was, in my standard, it was quite a unique performance yesterday.
Well, and we as audience agree with you. How do you stay focused when you're playing? Not to think about tomorrow or what happened yesterday. Or
You need to, you know, when you are sitting on piano, you need to totally into this music planet, what we call. You know, it's like when you come down to the stairs or when you go on to the stage, that's, you know, that 10 seconds of walking time is leading you into the music world. And when I sit down, I don't, you know, you are totally... forget, you know, the bills you need to pay. You get up tomorrow morning, you know, to catch another flight. Oh, this is the meeting I need to do after the concert. You don't think about it. You are totally into Allegro, you know, or, you know, you're totally into this ballad, you know, and you are, you know, changed somehow, and we transformed. It's a magical moment that, you know, you are totally into this music and start telling stories, you know, through music, through phrasing, you know, and you are into this very unusual magical moment that is so enjoyable.
Yeah.
You know, you just don't get disturbed from other, you know, normal living problems, or, you know, you just get so inspired.
Yeah. And so I think it was with the second piano concert of Chopin, all the teachers said, no, it's too difficult. Your father says, no, you can play it. And think about how you miss your mother. Think about the love of your mother. And that helped you to play it well, even when you were too young. It was too difficult. So
I was 12 and when I started learning the Chopin Concerto number 2. And it was... this is very, very romantic piece, and Chopin actually wrote it for his kind of first lover, you know. But he was very shy. He didn't talk, you know. He didn't really say it to her, but he wrote a piece to basically express his love for this girl. And I was 12, and I mean, it's very hard for me to have a romance that time. And it was very difficult to understand the most beautiful romantic, you know, longingness for someone, you know, for love. And remember, my father just said, you know, you should, because we left my mom at home to, you know, and we moved to Beijing and to study. And so,
and you were a
so
child,
I always
very,
couldn't,
very young,
you know,
yeah.
see my mom. And it's so sad. And it's so, for me, I always get really emotional when I think about my mom. I almost cry, you know, always. And then I start thinking about how I love her and how, you know, this missing, how much I miss her. And somehow, you know, from that moment, the emotion and the longingness and the sensitivities, the sensitive feelings, and it came through to the most beautiful music, I think, that Chopin produced, which is the second movement.
Yeah. So that was
beautiful.
The music, and it was your personal feeling, love.
Yeah,
for your mother,
you need to connect
combined.
Somehow. Otherwise, you just play the note. But you must find somehow. You need to connect. It's like you kind of connect with your soul through the music, of course. But we need to find that link.
Mm-hmm. Was it worthwhile all the sacrifices? You missed your childhood. Your father was there and said, study. Number one. That's what you're gonna be. Was it worthwhile? You're 28 now.
I mean, fortunately, I kind of, I'm quite lucky that I achieved my dream so far, you know, but so far, I mean, it's a long dream, it's just ahead of me, I'm still dreaming, but so far so good, and I think I'm quite lucky because there are also a lot of kids I know from China, from other part of the world, practice a lot, and the parents also made a huge sacrifice, huge, and many of them couldn't make it, of course. I mean, unfortunately.
But for you, it was worthwhile. All
yeah, but
the
for
years
me,
you
yeah.
missed with your mother, all the...
Honestly, I would, you know, I would like to have always, you know, when you're a little kid, you always want to have your mom, you know, near you, next to you, to, you know, to inspire you and to teach you and to have this great love, you know. But unfortunately, you know, because we... The economy, I mean, financially, we can't afford that time. So of course, if someday, you know, if people ask me, you know, whether if there's other way, do you like to do the same? I would say that I would like to bring my mom and to not make this kind of sacrifice. But one thing you can't avoid is to practice. I mean, that sacrifice you need to make.
Yeah. 6 hours, 8 hours, 10 hours a day.
Yeah, that's unfortunately, I mean, unfortunate, if you want to be a musician, that's the price you need to pay.
Yeah, dat is de prijs die je moet betalen. Zoveel uren studeren en dus zoveel opofferingen eigenlijk, want hij heeft toch zijn jeugd gemist. Dan ook praat bijzonder over Chopin en over hoe lastig dat was om dat als kind van 12 te spelen. Maar nu kan hij dat natuurlijk als geen ander. Van zijn nieuwste cd, Lang Lang, Chopin. zaten allemaal zo te luisteren naar Lang Lang dat we dachten Chopin te starten. Maar na één noot zei Lang Lang, dit is helemaal geen Chopin. Dit is Prokofjev, zevende sonate, tweede deel. Speelde hij gisteravond ook. I'm sorry, Mr. Lang Lang, but we liked Prokofjev as well. But we introduced it as a Chopin, but it wasn't a Chopin. We got a Chinese newspaper for you. Any news for you in the newspaper, or you follow it, all the news on the television?
Yeah, I mean, it's nice that Prince William is going to get married soon.
He's as old as you are, isn't
yeah,
he?
Yeah, actually, yeah, the same age.
Okay, about yeah. Marriage and
me, love? I'm not there yet.
You're not there yet. Are there any candidates?
Not yet.
Not yet. You live in New York, you live in Beijing, but, well, I say live, there's a house, but how much time can you spend in...
God, it's not so much. I mean, I think I spent 1 month this year in New York, not in the same time, but, you know, you just... and then probably 20 days in Beijing, that's it.
Well, that's it.
And yeah, but I had a holiday this summer, okay. Which is really great that I spent time in a kind of... beach club and with hot spring water, you know, to have a bath every day, and okay. that helps a lot to relax muscles and to get a recharging battery.
Okay, yeah. Very good. You just told me you've got dreams, and your dream came true, dream of being pianist, but I'm still dreaming. What are you dreaming about? What's your biggest wish?
Yeah, I'm actually working with a few charity projects, including myself, the Lang Lang International Music Foundation, that we are helping
stimulate young children. Musicians. Yeah.
Yes, and we have 8 scholars around the world, and to help them to have a great education and to have a wonderful opportunity to perform on stage. And they're very young, like 7 to 13 years old, so it's pre-teens.
Why is it so important for you to give your time to young people, to children?
Because, I mean, they are the future, and for me, I always had a great teachers, mentors, and I think that's, you know, in our world, it's a generation, 2 generation. It's almost like, you know, you listen to fairy tales from your father, and then, you know, and he listened to it from grandmother. So it's the same thing with classical music, with music. It's like that, you know, generation to generation knowledge. And we need to extend our great musicians what they did before, and we need to extend that.
I ask you about your dreams in life, and then you speak about young children. But when you try to be a little bit more personal, what's your personal
dream? That's my dream. Because
that's your dream.
Yeah, because, I mean, that's my priority. I like to help other kids to achieve their dreams, and that will make my dream much more fulfilling. Because, I mean, being a pianist, you can keep playing. Of course, you know, artistically, I need to keep improving. That's very important, you know, as an artist. There's no limit. So there's always new things to develop, to learn, to study. But in the same time, you know, we need to do something good to the society and to make classical music more approachable to everyone, not only to our great music listeners, but also to people who doesn't know and who doesn't have a chance to learn, which is also very important. Otherwise, you know, our world, I mean, the classical music world also need to expand a little bit. You know, we need to develop as every other fields, and we need to also, you know, use technologies and use multimedias and to share our thoughts a little bit more to people who like to know about what we are doing.
Yeah, and when you speak about development, your own development, Daniel Barenboim is your mentor. Is he the person who you can call and say, well, help me? I don't know.
I have a few mentors actually. I have a. Obviously, Daniel Barenboim is a great mentor. But also, in the same time, I have my other teachers, like Gary Graffman, who brought me to the West. Still, we are very close. And also a great person who's almost like my second father, Christoph Eschenbach. We kept very close relationships, always calling and you know, and meeting. I always play for him and to get...
And can I ask you, when do you call Daniel Barenboim? what kind, just say hello, but also with what kind of problem or uncertainty or when do you need
other
people?
For example, I mean, I little bit less now than before, but I remember that a few years ago, we meet every 2 months. I play for him and talk about music, talk about life, and what is the relationships between music and life,
what is the relationship between music and life?
Because I mean, what we are doing is actually reflect of what, you know, what is in our. I wouldn't say. If you're buying a fish and then that's in your music, I'm not saying that, but my point is that what do you think about life? You know, what is your way of experiencing how life should, you know, should you, what kind of life you should live in? And every piece reflect that, because it's from the beginning to the end, it's from the born to the death, you know, and you basically every time when you play a work, from the first note, you start the journey, you know, of a whatever, and you can think about of a human being, or you can think about that's a beautiful dog, or you can think about that's a beautiful country, you know, you can whatever, you know, or you can think about that's ugly war, you know, I mean, it's every piece has their own world to express, and you just need to connect with. What you know, not necessarily your life experience, but something that you can feel it, and you can. It's almost like a great actor, you know, when you acting different roles. What you have, you know, sometimes you need to be a comedy star, sometimes you need to be a drama star, you know, sometimes you need to be, you know, fantasy, you know, type of. Fiction or nonfiction or whatever. I mean, there are a lot of. A lot of different characters you need to build in, and music is like that. You build characters through music notes.
You look at the piano. What do you think now? It's the variation Kabalevsky. I think you did on the first contest when you were five.
Yeah, I absolutely remember that.
Okay.
Yeah.
Can you play it by heart? Or yeah? Well, there's the music.
That one I played. I remember.
Like to sit down, it's all right with me. Do you know? Okay, that's not all for today, I think.
Yeah.
You're going to practice today too?
Today, no.
For the concert? No.
I think yesterday I practiced a lot. I practiced 3 hours before a concert and then played 2 hours. I think today I will, you know, make my muscles relax a little bit.
And when your father would be here at this particular moment, when I read your book, your father says always, no, 6 hours, 8 hours,
no,
10
no,
hours
I mean,
per
no,
day,
no,
but
no, no,
that's
no, no,
all
no,
over?
No. You can't do that because, I mean, when you were a kid, yes.
Yeah.
You practice that hard, but, you know.
Did your father ever say sorry for what I did?
No,
sorry what
no,
I asked
never.
From you?
No. Never. Never.
Would you expect it from him?
No,
sort of.
I
sorry.
Don't. Because that's my father. You know, he's a very strong personality. He means good stuff, and sometimes he just, you know, a little bit too you know, extreme. But he never says sorry. No, that's not. I mean, I don't know whether it's a good thing or a bad thing, but he never say that. Yeah.
Okay.
My mom sometimes say it, but.
Yeah. Okay. We have Chopin now. You're playing Chopin Etude, Opus
25, number one.
What expresses this music for you?
It's very beautiful. I mean, once I got a little bit tired of or depressed when I travel too much, I start playing this piece, and it's everything is all those bad impression disappeared. Soft in music itself. So this is great music that makes people really relax and feel loved.
Lang Lang met muziek van Frédéric Chopin, Etude opus 25, nummer 1. Muziek waar je een beetje bij kan wegdromen en als je somber bent, of als je zelf somber is, dan helpt deze muziek hem ook. You seem so relaxed. What are you worried about? Society, children, environment? Please, with this chair a little bit closer, or I can do it with the microphone.
There's nothing to worry about. I mean, I think we just need to take the action. And, you know, if you don't like something, if you want to change something, take action and fix the problem. And there's no, you know, no major worries.
You're not worried about, no? No, nothing.
There's no worries. Seriously.
How can you say that when you look around and you see you're also for UNICEF and when you went into Africa, you saw the people living
there? Oh, you mean that kind of?
That kind of worries.
That, of course. Yeah. I mean, that's yes. But I mean, you know, my personal, I mean, I'm not worried about myself. But obviously, if you're talking about, that's the reason I'm doing charity, because there's a lot of problems, you know, that in the world that need to fix. Not only in poverty, but more is that sometimes people, kid doesn't get enough attention, you know, when they don't have family, they live very poor. I mean, I was living in a very poor place as well when I was a kid, but at least, you know, we get a lot of love, a lot of great attention, great help. And one thing in life is that it's okay to be poor, to be, you know, to live in a some kind of
humble circumstances,
you know. But if you have a dream, if you are, you know, working on your dream, if you have the right track, then it's okay, because eventually a lot of things will change.
And that's what you want to do, help children with realizing their dreams or to
yeah, but yeah. For me, the one thing I'm not worried, but I concern, what I concern is that classical music is not played often in everyday life, basically. I mean, the normal, you know, little kids, and mm-hmm. they don't really listen to classical, and there's no such education exists anymore. It's like school cutting a lot of budget for orchestra, and that's a huge concern, because obviously I understand, you know, people say that, oh, because culture doesn't make money, you know, but the world is not just about money. I mean, it's about also we need to have a great spiritual feelings.
You've got time to for reflection, for spiritual feelings.
For me, when I perform, that's you know, that's gave me the chance to reflecting and spiritual. You know, for musicians, we are always quite spiritual people, because when you play music, that's, you know, that's spiritual time.
That's at most, yeah.
And I know how this, you know, how much I gain from this great art, and I really hope that more kids will realize it and to, you know, to also practice a little bit and to feel it, you know, and I believe it's a very good balance to kids to growing up, and I believe that's 100% and I support this initiative, you know, with all my heart, and I really hope that the parents will help us also a little bit, because, you know, parents help. It's very powerful, especially the kids when they were really young.
It's also
young.
Your personal feeling.
Yeah, it's yeah. For me. I mean, yeah. Because music changed my life, and I believe it's very powerful. You know, I really believe it's a great power, but with such a peaceful messages.
Yeah. And now you're world famous, and you say in your book, "I don't use the word proud. I'm not proud." Why don't you use the word proud? You've got every reason to be proud what you achieved in life.
I'm quite happy, and I quite feel very fortunate and appreciate. No time to be proud, because there are a lot of things I'm not good at. I need to
give
improve.
An example.
I mean, it's no example. It's just I know it in my heart, you know, but it's hard to express what is good or what is bad, because in art, it's sometimes it's hard to judge. But I know there's a lot of things I need to keep learning, and so there's no time to be proud, but okay. There is a time for me to get to the next level.
Okay. Flight of the Bumblebee. I think it was one of your encores in 2005 with the Meester Pianiste.
All right.
Yeah?
Yes,
okay.
Yes.
That's you.
Yes.
Flight of the Bumblebee, that was you, by Rimsky-Korsakov, that was you playing in 2005 in the Concertgebouw. You say you listen to it, but then I play it, it was quite good.
That was good.
Yeah.
Yeah, quite happy about it.
Yeah, don't apologize for thinking something is good. We like to play you with Beethoven. Do you like that?
Yes, absolutely. I think the second movement of the first sonata.
Okay.
Second movement. Adagio.
Second movement.
Adagio.
Okay.
Track Adagio. Number two, okay. Please.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, there's a CD and a paper. Let's see, precies. Just play a little part.
Yeah,
okay,
please.
A little part. Okay.
I love it. It's so beautiful, this piece.
Lang Lang, piano-fenomeen Lang Lang met het adagio uit de derde pianosonate van Ludwig van Beethoven. Thank you very much indeed for giving some of your time. Wish you all the best.
Thank you so much. In your personal life
and your professional life. Thank you so much.
Pleasure,
so
such much. A pleasure.
Thank
and
you.
Thanks for everyone who listens today. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Goed, dit was de klassieker van vandaag. Morgen weer gewoon uit Hilversum. Eind van de maand, laatste vrijdag, zijn we weer bij een van u. Nu, na het nieuws, ligt op 4... met Maartje Stokkers. Vanuit Amsterdam, vanuit Okura. Met Lang Lang aan tafel, die meespeelt met zijn handen, met de muziek die u op cd hoort. Goedemiddag.
Spannende muzikale mix.
Vanmiddag van 3 tot 4.